record.
Hello everybody, this is your boy MRCT aka
Rock City.
And you watching Spotlight Report. Right about now.
Skiddly down 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 dang.
Tell me, would you really cry for me?
Would you really cry for me?
Baby, don't lie to me.
Baby, don't lie to me.
If I didn't have anything, I wanna know, would you stick around?
If I got locked away and we lost it all today, tell me honestly, would you still love me the same?
Welcome to Australia. You guys surprised some people at the Maroon 5 concert in Sydney the other day. What were the Aussie fans like?
Oh man, the Aussie fans have been very excited to see us, which is a surprise to us because we've never been. You know, this is our first big song over here in Australia, and you know,
well, this is our first big song
in the world,
period.
You know, yeah, period. And just coming over to Australia, and like I say, we did Melbourne, we did Brisbane, and I ain't gonna lie, every time Adam says, everybody rocks it in, the crowd erupts, and we like,
yeah,
oh man, okay, cool. You know, it's crazy. So we, you know, the love has been tremendous. We've been happy, feeling blessed, and just excited.
And what was it like to collaborate with Adam on the track Locked Away?
Man, it was awesome, you know, just to have somebody of, you know, that level to be a part of your music and to, you know, and to respect and admire your work. Because, you know, when Dr. Luke approached him to ask him to do a song with us, and he was like, yo, I heard of them from writing, but just to let you know, I can't say I'm gonna do it. I have to hear the music first. And he heard the music, man, and loved Locked Away. So yeah, that's like, yo, that's a big compliment. Somebody like, he's written some of the best songs ever. So it's like, just for him to respect our work and be a part of it is really cool.
So before we just talk about your album for a second, I just wanted to sort of introduce you to Australian fans. So if you could tell us about how you began in the music industry.
Yeah, we started, you know, as artists. You know, I know some people might be familiar with our songwriting history, but I can get to that part. But we didn't start as writers and then turn into artists. We started out as artists. We are from St. Thomas, Virgin Islands, born and raised. We are real brothers, same mother, same father, and we grew up in the projects, we came from the slums, and we wanted to do music, man. Our parents was lovers of music. We grew up in a household on an island, believe it or not, where our father played a lot of hip-hop music in the house, as well as reggae music, roots reggae like Steel Pulse, Bob Marley, stuff like that. And we just had a huge love for hip-hop music and the whole hip-hop culture. We started out just, you know, mimicking all the dance moves we would see in all the rap videos. And then Criss Cross came out, and you know, we were really young and we were like, yo, that was the first time we really wanted to pick up the microphone, and we were just doing it in the house. My father saw what we're doing right now back then at that moment. So my father would have us go around the island performing, and then before you know it, we became the biggest group, biggest hip hop group in the Virgin Islands. And we, you know, you can't really make no real money in the Virgin Islands doing hip hop music. So we decided to move to the States after we graduated out of high school. And we moved to the States chasing our dreams. We went to Miami at first. We went to Miami for maybe like 7-8 months. And you know, things were moving slow. So we felt like we needed to be in either Atlanta or New York. And we got a phone call or an email from a local Virgin Islands promoter about doing a show in Atlanta. We took that as a sign, we went to Atlanta and we never left. And then we were just grinding, doing talent shows. That was our way of paying our bills and surviving, because you would win money at these talent shows. We started winning so much that they told us we couldn't compete no more. And then we were like, man, we gotta figure out another hustle then. And then that's how we kind of land our way into writing songs. It kind of happened by mistake. And then when we realized that we could make a living and make, you know, really good money writing songs for other artists, which we capitalized over that moment, and then that's how we get into writing songs. And now we have written songs for Usher, Chris Brown, Rihanna, Miley Cyrus, Jennifer Hudson, Leona Lewis, R. Kelly, Becky G, you know, a lot of great, great artists who we, you know, admire and respect talent-wise and just as people. And then we decided to put being an artist on hold, because it's hard trying to be an artist and a songwriter on the come up. So we was like, you know something, as much as we love our artistry and that's our dream, we have to be smart enough to know let's put one thing on hold. Writers, they're calling us to write songs right now. Let's write songs. And God willing, let's get hot as songwriters. And we know, you know, the opportunity will present itself again for us to go full speed as an artist. And that's how we meet up with Dr. Luke through a mutual friend. Start working on songs for our artist. He have signed to him named Becky G. And then eventually we start working on songs for ourselves, signed to Dr. Luke. And then here we are, locked away.
Ta-da!
Do you think being in the behind the scenes songwriting has influenced your music as artists now? So you said you started as artist, but do you think your process has changed from the beginning?
Oh man, our process of writing music from the beginning has definitely changed because, you know, seeing just the industry and working on other artists and the process of how that works and how a label decides to release a song and how it's set up, you know, definitely gave us the education and understanding while working on our album to understand the kind of music that we wanted to make and also needed to make, you know, So I definitely, it played a big role and it helped a lot because, you know, I just feel like now with our album, we went into it like with a real goal and a real understanding of what we felt our city hit sound like. Not, you know, who knows, the world gonna decide, but we felt like, yo, this is what our city hit supposed to sound like, you know.
So when you're writing a song for somebody else, how does that process differ to when you're writing for yourself?
Well, when we're writing a song for someone else, the difference between writing for them and us is basically, when we write for Rihanna, we know Rihanna, we talk to her, we understand what she wants, how she feels, what does she want to say, and we write about that. That's her story, her moment, and that's how she will express herself. When writing music for ourselves, it's our story, our new moment, how we want to express ourselves. Like, take for instance, Locked Away is about our father and our mother. Our dad went to jail for 5 years. Our mother stayed with him. Our parents been together for 38 years, you know, and basically
still together
right now. So the whole existence of that song was based on a personal experience that we have been told about our whole entire life, seen firsthand, and that's where our music comes from. Our music comes from a deep place and we try to bring it to the people, you know, in the best way we can.
Yeah, so let's talk about your album now. What Dreams Are Made Of. What can you tell me about that?
If you see our album cover, it's a picture of me and my brother as kids when we was the ages of 3 and 4 years old. And that alone, you know, it tells you that this is a dream we've been chasing since we were 3 and 4 years old. A love and a passion and a desire to do music and make our own music and perform our songs to the world. And, you know, we don't make music for ourselves. We make music for the people, even though it's from a personal place and we're talking about our life and our stories and our struggles. We still want to make sure we do it in a way that the people that are listening to our music could relate to, where they could own it as their life, their story, their experience. You know what I mean? Because we all go through a lot of similar stuff in this world. And I feel like if, you know, you could put in a song in a way that people could relate to, those make some of the best songs. So for our album, we just wanted to tell our story and make great music for the people, man. You know, we're fans of music. There's so much great artists and so much great music out there that we admire and appreciate. And we just wanted to make great music, man. Music that would make people happy, make people smile throughout the day, inspire people, uplift them, make them feel better about themselves, make them feel hopeful, you know, when they feel like there may not be any hope for something that they might be going through. And, you know, our album, we tried our best to do all of that in one album. And, you know, again, we grew up listening to hip-hop music, reggae music, and our album is a blend of both genres, hip-hop and Caribbean music, you know. And to the world outside of the Caribbean, reggae music is pop music, you know what I mean? But to the Caribbean, reggae music is reggae music. Exactly. You know what I mean? We don't put a label on it as far as pop, urban, is reggae music, you know what I mean? So, you know, our music is Caribbean meets hip-hop. And just, you know, great songs, at least in our opinion. But the fans, the consumers, they're gonna be the ones to judge it
on October 9th. You will be the judge.
Yeah, October 9th, which is only a few days away, man. And, you know, we're definitely excited. This is our first major album released to the world. And that's what dreams are made of. Coming from where we come from, you know, our story, our struggles, you know, from sleeping at the train to being homeless to, you know what I mean? Like, everything that we've been through to be where we at right now, coming from a small 32 square mile island, that's what dreams are made of.
And what kind of artists inspire the Caribbean hip-hop?
I mean, basically all the American artists. I mean, it's, you know, it's basically like how the whole entire world is, just how, you know, hip-hop starting in New York City, and everybody from other countries basically watching it grow and blossom and being influenced by it. If you in Australia, if you in Germany, if you in Africa, if you in St. Thomas, you watch, you know, BET, MTV, the internet, you watching these things and you're just fascinated by this lifestyle and culture, and you interpret it in your way and you take it and you point into your lifestyle.
You put your own twist on it.
Yeah.
And you make it your own.
Your own. So just, you know, growing up watching BET and MTV and stuff like that, watching music videos, it's like, you know, I'm playing our own spin on it, you know, because like I say, we are Caribbean and that's our culture, so just blending our culture with that culture and trying to make it our own thing.
Are you worried that that might rub some shoulders the wrong way? Because hip-hop culture is such a strong culture, and same with the Caribbean and reggae culture. So do you think the cultural appropriation of having both of them together will work, or do you think that it might annoy some people?
I hope it don't. I mean, you know, when hip hop was started in New York, it was, you know, it was started by a DJ that was from Jamaica. You know what I'm saying? And that's definitely how hip hop and the Caribbean culture coexist. You know, we are Caribbean, you know what I'm saying? We are influenced by this is how I feel. When you make something, from the way that we dress to the way that we talk to the way that we walk, we do things and we influence people. That's the purpose, to influence somebody else and inspire them to do something. You know what I'm saying? And art, you know, great art mimics great art. And I feel like if you see something that you love, you take a piece of it, and that's where originality comes from. So I feel like the Caribbean, as of right now, all the world for us is the Caribbean has been very proud of us. You know what I'm saying? And they're very happy with what we're doing and what we've been accomplishing and representing the Caribbean. And I think hip-hop fans and hip-hop artists will embrace what we're doing too, because it's different. And hip-hop has always stood for originality. And I think Rock City is very original.
Yeah, that totally makes sense. Yeah, no, I agree. That's a good answer. So, like, do you feel like the closeness, because you're brothers, you can't write honest lyrics together? Do you find that sometimes you might have like a conflict because of your closeness, or do you feel like it does the opposite? Because you're so close, you're able to write honestly together?
I think, yeah, like because we're so close, we definitely could write honestly together. And you know, our life is an open book as far as stuff that we've been through and we've experienced. And you know, I feel like a story is not a great story if you leave out the really, really good parts. Mm-hmm. And the really, really good parts might be bad stuff, but that's what makes the story great. The fact that you were willing to share that with the world, it was like, I've been through it. I did this. Yeah, it was messed up, but I was at a place in my life where I didn't really understand the difference between that being messed up versus this being the right thing to do, and I made a bad choice. But I is a better person now because I learned from that. You know what I mean? And when you could share those type of stuff with the world and just to show them like, yo, I've grown, I've become better, or yeah, we all make mistakes. I am perfect. Though please don't put me on a pedestal. You know what I mean? Because I'm human just like you human. We all make mistakes. So I feel, you know, honest music, honest movies, honest stories is always the best. And for us, it's easy because we're brothers. So, you know, we'll be like, nah. I might be telling him like, nah, see the real, say what really happened.
Yeah.
Don't sugarcoat it, because the people, they don't want to hear the sugarcoated version. The people, they want to hear the real version. And as people, as fans of life and everything that happens in this world, one of the things that we appreciate is real.
Yes.
Initially taking those songs to the stage, is that daunting for you, or you really are very open about, you know, your past, and you'd like people to open up and take those experiences
taking our story and message to the stage, you know, that's the most important thing. That's why we do it. You know what I mean? This is the thing. Honesty mixed with music is the most powerful thing in the world. You know, we performed in Maroon 5 in Melbourne and there were what, 20, 30, 40,000 people in a room. And if Adam Levine or T-Ron Thomas, Timothy Thomas said, everybody in this room, hold hands, put your hands in the air and say, I love everybody. Everybody in the room would have did it. People that don't like each other, people that would pass each other in the street and not talk to each other. So I feel like, you know, our story and our message and music, that's probably one of the only things on the planet that could do that. You know what I mean? So it would never be daunting that the fact that I could come in and bare myself, you know, my naked truth and my ugly parts, and you look at me and say, man, I love him for that, and I love this moment, and I shared it with this total stranger, but now did we just become best friends?
That just happened,
you know what I mean? And because of our truth, truth is love, man. Truth is love.
Cool, so we took some fun questions from some fans.
Let's do it.
What has been the highlight of your career so far?
This locked away, honestly.
It's two things. This, definitely. And being able to move our parents out of the projects, that's probably by far the first biggest accomplishment and one of the most proud moments for me and my brother.
Definitely.
To be able to do that, because I feel like they deserve it. 38 years strong, the greatest parents ever. We grew up in a project around a lot of crazy stuff, but having both parents in our life, supporting our music from the time we were kids to till now, is we couldn't ask for a better set of parents. So that's definitely one of the most exciting things.
Even though this is probably hard to imagine for you guys since you've been making music so long, but if you weren't making music, what would you be doing?
Making music.
honestly, we've never really been into anything else. We've been doing this. If you see our album cover, we were 3 and 4 years old. So, I mean, I don't think there was any room for us to be anything else.
And lastly, where's the strangest place you've heard your song being played?
An electronic store. I was in Atlanta and I was going to buy a flat screen TV. And I was like, oh man, and just so happens, our video just pop up on like four of the screens. Cause you know in them stores that play the same thing. So as I in there like, yeah, I wanna get this one. Boom! I was like, this is awesome, it was meant to be, and I bought the TV.
Well, there you go. Cool, thank you.